Listen, I want to turn now to Tony Perkins. He's the president of the Family Research Council. Good evening, Mr. Perkins. Thank you for joining us.
Good evening.
You support Ted Cruz. He has won four states. Will he win any of the contests this weekend, you think, in Kansas, Kentucky, Maine, or Louisiana?
Well, we'll see tomorrow night. About this time tomorrow night, the returns will be back in, and we'll see. He's doing very competitively in some of these states. My home state of Louisiana, I've been campaigning for him. Tonight, we've got a big rally in South Louisiana. It's a capacity crowd. I think he's going to do well. I mean, we look at the delegate counts. He's actually doing quite well. He's less than 100 votes behind, or delegates behind Donald Trump, and I think he is the best option. If all this discussion about stopping Donald Trump, the best way is to rally around Ted Cruz.
I must ask you about the debate last night. It was raucous and raw with talk of sexual prowess, among other things. Does Senator Ted Cruz think that this is the best way to take on Donald Trump, to have a debate that hits such lows to people that people can't even watch with their own kids?
You know, that's a really good point, but most of that was between Marco Rubio and Donald Trump. And I agree with you. Most of these debates at this point have lacked substance. Last night, it looked like people on the schoolyard elbowing and pushing and shoving. Although I will say that Ted Cruz, he came forth with casting visions on foreign policy, on the economy domestically, and I think he stood out. I thought last night was probably his best debate. I am very concerned. If you were to take a snapshot of these Republican debates and what it says about America, it is disheartening, and I think the Republicans have to do better than Donald Trump and Marco Rubio sparring back and forth with name calling, and it's just unacceptable.
I'm sure you've heard this, and you may have had the chance to listen to Gloria Borges' interview with Mitt Romney, but he's encouraging Republicans to vote for the candidate who's strongest in each state except Trump in order to deny Trump enough delegates to get the nomination. Does Senator Cruz agree with that strategy?
I think he is going out to win as many delegates and states as he possibly can. I have respect for Mitt Romney. I supported him when he ran in 2012. But quite frankly, I think him coming out and attacking Donald Trump as he did, whether what he said or not is true, and I think most of what he said is accurate or close to it, that actually helps Donald Trump because Mitt Romney is seen as part of the establishment. Look, people are angry. They're frustrated. They're fearful of the future. Donald Trump is saying things that people can connect with. That's the reason you're seeing people turn out. They're frustrated with Republicans who have overpromised and underperformed. The difference is Ted Cruz, we believe, is the solution to that problem.
So Ted Cruz is now attacking Trump largely on his record as well and his temperament. But why did it take so long?
Well, because quite frankly, you know, in my discussions with Senator Cruz, once I personally endorsed him, is to cast our discussions about casting a vision, to bring Americans to that vision and lead them forward and not get involved in that, in the name calling, the back and forth that really this campaign, this primary has become really at a low level. And he has, for the most part, stayed above that fray, which I'm thankful for. There is clearly the room for and the need for to draw contrast between policies. And quite frankly, Donald Trump has not talked about policies at all. It's very shallow. He does not get very deep beyond the wall what he's going to do. And I think it's very important that Americans have an understanding of the policy prescriptions that these candidates are presenting.
We know politics is a really strange business, a strange profession, but I have to ask you this, Tony. Given all the terrible things that Cruz and Rubio and others in the party say about Donald Trump, how can they still say that they're going to support him as the nominee?
You know, it's a great question. I mean, when all these things are said and done, I think the problem will be is that there will be a lot of conservatives, a lot of evangelicals in particular, in the general election if Donald Trump is the nominee. They won't vote for him. And that's not speculation, Don. That's based upon what happened in 2008 and 2012.
But he's getting a lot of support from evangelicals, though.
Well, there's two aspects to that. One is evangelicals are not that much different than the rest of the society when it comes to what's happening in the world around us. Many of them are being driven by fear of what's happening in this world, and frustration, as I mentioned earlier, with the Republicans. But the term evangelical is a little bit of, there's some elasticity to that term, and it's being used more broadly than I think historically it has been used. So when you actually look, like Reuters broke it down, and those who attend church on a weekly basis and are very serious about their faith and it, in terms of it guiding their lives, those more than not either went for Ted Cruz or Ben Carson in these elections up to this point. The good news is we're actually seeing more people turn out and participate in the process.
I've got to go. Tony Perkins, Family Research Council, thank you.
All right, great to be with you.